Nice. So we're checking out the only game where you can see what would happen to us if every nuke on the entire planet went off at once. It's Solar Smash. Solar Smash is one of those games that ended up being deeper and more accurate than I had previously anticipated. This sounds really morbid, but it gives you a pretty accurate representation of what happens when you blow up different parts of the Earth in the death tolls. And so today I want to find out exactly what would happen if every nuke on the planet went off at once. I'm also going to do other torturous stuff to the planet because honestly, that's exactly what Solar Smash is good at. You basically use the planet like it's like carving a turkey, except instead of turkey, it's people. You may be asking yourself, but Gray, how many nukes are there on the planet? I have no idea, but what I do have is Google. Hey Google, how many nukes are on the planet?
Here's a summary from our world in data.
Okay,
the
I just needed the number. I just needed the number. Stop. How do I turn you off? Stop it. Now there's a few things here to recognize for our test. First off, in the game, whenever you send the nukes, you get 4 for the price of 1. Let me give you an example. Let's say you're chilling out down here in Florida with me getting skin cancer when all of a sudden, 4 nukes decide to completely miss the state. Not only is your college frat party-esque carnival cruise completely obliterated, but you also ended up losing 48 million people in the process. Now, due to totally diligent nuclear warhead testing that I did online that probably put me on some sort of FBI watch list, I have found that your typical nuclear warhead will kill around 1 million people in a highly populated area. Well, it'll instantly kill 1 million people. A bunch of other people will probably die because we're good at that. After everyone gets cancer and is sad, if we say there's 5 million people die in total, because who the hell knows how fast time is moving here, we can say that these bombs are approximately 2.5 times more powerful than your average bomb. What is an average bomb? I don't know. Look, this is a game with death rays, okay? Actually, you know what? Hold on. Let me give you an actual real-life example of what these bombs are like using the overwhelmingly screwed up power that Google has over us all. Welcome to planet Earth. Does this look somewhat familiar? So there is a way to translate explosions onto this map, which happens to render every single thing in 3D. You think I'm kidding? Hold on. Yes, it can go straight to street mode, so you can look at some place called the House of Carbs. Okay, so let's go ahead and detonate the largest explosive we can here to see if it's at least slightly reminiscent to what we have in Solar Smash. Welcome to Nuke Map. It's the site that makes me realize that I'm not alone in how screwed up I am. So Nuke Map allows you to set an impact for a nuclear warhead of any one of these types here. I like how they're giving anime names to stuff that are nuclear warheads. Apparently we call this the Ivy King. All the way at the bottom here, we have the SAR bomb. Go ahead and grab this real quick. Basic options, casualties. Eh, what the hell? Go ahead and throw that on there. Radioactive fallout, sure. See the crater, mushroom cloud dimension. And then the big deal over here, making sure to export this into our Google Earth. Okay, let's go ahead and detonate. Oh, shit. Okay, so this area right here is the fireball. To give you an idea of what the fireball means, it means anything inside the fireball is effectively vaporized. See this different section of yellow over here? You would think maybe this is slightly less bad than this section of yellow. It's the thermal radiation radius. Third-degree burns extend throughout the layers of the skin, but are often painless because they destroy the pain nerves. Now we get to see this in full 3D. When you can see the mushroom cloud from space, that's a bad sign. All right, let's go ahead and scroll over here. Yeah, the mushroom cloud is, it's the entire width of Florida. It's just offset, so some of it happens to be in the ocean. And let's go down real quick here to see exactly what happened. First, I have to travel alongside the freaking cloud of death. Okay, so this is what we're dealing with so far. This is the fireball. This is an entire city, by the way, here. Go ahead and move in.
So sorry, Tampa.
Just traveling over here to the fireball. You'll notice that the sky isn't blue anymore. Do you know what the color of the sky is? It's sadness. Yeah, anything in yellow here, this is all the fireball. All this. We're still going. Still traveling along the highway here through within the fireball. And remember, while this area may be, you know, the second sun, this entire area here inward is still getting third degree burns that are burning out their pain receptors. Let me just show you what this would have looked like from my house, which is, you know, like 300 miles away. Welcome to my neighborhood. What is that in the distance? It's Gray still plays screwing around in 2020. I don't know if we can get the casualty amount any higher. What's really populated? Here we go. Yep, you can get the casualty number a lot higher. All right, let's get back to blowing shit up. So it looks like I'm gonna have to click on this 1,000 times in order to determine just how much destruction will come from 10,000 nukes going off on the planet. Also, this was totally an accident. This is the only game where you can accidentally click your left mouse button and kill 500 million people. Okay, we're gonna set our auto clicker over here for 1,000 times. I'm gonna center this on Florida because honestly, with all the nukes going off, we should be fine. We're highly resistant to radiation down here anyway. I'm serious. You ever look at the weather channel in Florida? You know how it says like the UV radiation reports? It usually goes from like 1 to 10. Ours is always at 11. Like at 10 o'clock at night, it's still at 11. Our state bird is melanoma. Batman doesn't fight crime at night because he wants to be a bat. He fights crime at night because he used to live in Florida and he knew that going out in the day would kill him immediately with skin cancer. All right, let's blow up the world. Go, my son. I like how before I couldn't hit Florida worth a damn at all. And this time it was like a perfect shot. We've only killed 150 million people. Never mind, the entire planet just folded in on itself. Okay, hold on. No. Okay, real quick, new plan for the 1,000 nukes. Maybe if I spread it around a little bit. Alrighty, everyone gets some nukes today. Oh yeah, we're painting a beautiful picture here. Plus, we've gotten 600 million people dead already. Alright. Yeah, it doesn't take too much before the radiation amount of all the nukes just completely obliterate the entire planet. I still want to see how big the crater is once all 10,000 nukes go off. Okay, all 10,000 nukes are finally done. It doesn't look too bad, right? How about now? Okay, so I want to find out what happens to the United States if people who aren't us use their nuclear warhead amounts upon us. For instance, it says that the UK has 120 deployed nuclear warheads. Now that would be about 15 clicks of this button to determine exactly how much damage they would do to us. However, everyone that shoots nukes in this game is horribly intoxicated because the aim is awful. All right, that's all 15 right there. I'm pretty sure that everyone in the United States is dead, and most of Mexico is dead too. And actually, doesn't like 70% of Canada live like right here? So they didn't make it either. I think what's funny is the inherent death of the planet isn't exactly related to the amount of damage that happens to the surface. Let me give you an example of something. I am going to remove 1/4 of the entire planet. I'm serious. If the planet was a pizza made of depression and there's 8 slices, I'm taking 2 of the slices away. So right down the middle here. On the plus side, California's gonna be okay, huh? Who's on this side over here? No, Africa and Australia are fine. All right, so you go about halfway here and then you just go straight like this. This is one of those instances where you get asked, they're like, what did it cost? And you're like, about 4 billion people. All right, now let me just clean up my mess here. I'm not gonna lie, now I'm partly curious just how much of the earth I can slowly evaporate away. There you go, 2 slices. I'm like an irresponsible college-age Thanos. I have legitimately cored away a quarter of the entire planet, and somehow it still survives. I mean, 4.5 billion people would beg to differ, but you know what I mean. Actually, the thing that this taught us the most is that the inside of the planet looks like a delicious Cadbury cream egg. When we crack the Earth open like this, now I'm starting to wonder just how much damage we can do and keep this thing alive. If I just, you know, it's all ocean down here, right? There's really no one living in this area. Hold on, if I just remove kind of like this bottom piece, you know, not too much. Son of a bitch, the Earth just died. Okay, how about if I put a black hole in the core of the Earth? Why would I do such a thing? I don't know. It seemed like a good idea at the time. All right, just slow things way down. Go ahead and click right about here. Oh, yeah. That black hole started in just the place I would want it to. Now, as long as my positioning is good, no one else has to die. Never mind. Everyone immediately died. There was about 70 million people that were left just long enough to see the evaporation of the core of the Earth. I hadn't really planned on doing this, but I guess I'm turning the Earth into Pac-Man. It's like one of those surprise egg things that everyone does on YouTube. I'm just putting a black hole on the North and South Pole to see if the Earth could, you know, survive this. Considering I shaved the entire top and bottom of the Earth off, turning it flat and it survived, it annoys me that this was too much. I just burrowed moons through the Earth, and the Earth was okay with that. Look at the hole!
hole it made. The original hole that I punched through the earth with the laser is nothing compared to this.
I mean, can I make the hole a little bit wider? What if I kind of... I mean, there has to be a limit, right? It has to stop me eventually. Okay, there we go. I'd like you to watch with me as this happens so you can watch the other side of the earth vomit out moons. It kind of looks like it's taking a crap. Okay, how about now? Can I put a black hole in here now and still have the planet survive it? Damn it. Okay, how about if I go in through this middle as well as the top and the bottom? Come on, Earth. I know you're not that fragile. All right, maybe you are. In my ways of attempting to torture the Earth without having it immediately implode in upon itself, I decided to find out what would happen if I made the Earth a lot thinner. I'm not talking about flat Earth. I'm talking about, like, what would happen if the sphere that makes up the Earth was just a lot smaller. Like this. I'm basically turning the Earth into a half-eaten pear. God forbid I take away more than a quarter off of the slice area, the Earth immediately dies. But get rid of about, like 200 miles of topsoil straight down, that's fine. And right there, that was the limitation. Great, I turned Earth into a cancerous wine cork. I didn't intend to make Jack Skellington here. What I actually want to do is throw the moon so that they're not completely going through the Earth. Hey, let me show you. If I take the moons and I go like up here, okay? And then we slow things down so we get the opportunity to see this. Now what this should do is this should take like a small C-section out of the Earth. Yeah, right? Like there, perfect. All right, now let's do that right over here. Okay, the Earth's still alive. We're getting somewhere. Starting to look like a pair of briefs. Okay, now I'm starting to wonder exactly how the hell this game calculates death. Because the Earth is still alive. There's 1.4 billion people left. Look at what I have done. God forbid there should be a little bit of ocean and greenery. Hold on, let me clear this up over here. Okay, that finally did it. I needed to try something real quick because it seems like the moon just doesn't count as much for surface damage for some reason. So I'm wondering what happens if I throw a moon at all of these very, very volatile Borg-like explosive spheres. All right, so here it is coming in contact. Right around here is my computer having an epileptic seizure. You can very slowly see part of the Earth getting pissed off. Well, 1.4 billion people are dead, and I have what looks like the indentation of a bloody snowman in the planet. I wanted to see if I could turn Earth into an egg. There is one last thing that I want to see if I can do with the Earth. This is something I've always wanted. I've always wanted a square Earth. Not a flat Earth, per se. I mean, it is flat, you know, on all the different sides, but I mean like an equidistant flatness. All right, Earth, I need you to do me a favor. You need to not die until I say you can.
I'm so close. It's so beautiful.
It's like a die whose sole purpose is to make people wish they were dead.
There it is.
This square Earth. I might even be able to get it smaller. Just taking a little bit off the top here. It's like basically giving the Earth a crew cut. Not gonna lie, that came out pretty perfectly. At this point, I'm just trying to get it smaller and smaller for posterity. I like how completely changing the shape of the Earth only costed me a currency of 2.3 billion lives. It wasn't my intent to have most of the United States still alive. Maybe I can take more off the top. This is like when you go to the barber and you're like, yeah, just a couple of inches. And your mom is always like, make it short. There we go. How much farther can I make this happen?
No! Okay, it was a good square though. The fact that I got the square of the Earth down that much and it still survived was pretty sweet.
I mean, at this point, this means that there's pretty much only one thing left to do here.
Well, folks, hope y'all enjoyed this episode of Solar Smack. Till the next time, stay foxy and much love.